Suppose the region R is the finite region bounded by f of x equals the square root of x and g of x equals x divided by 4. Looking at the graph below, this indicates the region R is this bounded region here. We're asked to find the exact value of the volume of the object when rotating the bounded area about the x-axis, and then for part B, find the exact value of the volume when rotating about the y-axis. We'll be using the washer method, and the notes are shown below. When we have a horizontal axis of rotation, we integrate with respect to x, and big R of x and little r of x are functions of x. Big R of x is the outer radius, little r of x is the inner radius. When we have a vertical axis of rotation, we integrate with respect to y, and big R and little r must be functions of y. To help set this up, it's important to have the graph of the bounded region and also to sketch a representative rectangle that is perpendicular to the axis of rotation. The representative rectangle would be one washer of the volume when rotated about the given axis. Let's first consider part A when rotating the region R about the x-axis. If we rotate the region R about the x-axis, we have the volume shown below, where again this is the region R, and the two points of intersection of the two functions are 0, 0, the origin, and this point here, which is 16, 4. We could also determine these points of intersection algebraically by solving y equals the square root of x and y equals x divided by 4 as a system of equations. And again, for part A, we're rotating about the x-axis, which means the representative rectangle is going to be perpendicular to the x-axis and look something like this. Notice the thickness of the rectangle is delta x, which is why we integrate with respect to x. And the outer radius, big R of x, is this distance, which we can see is going to be equal to the square root function. And the inner radius is going to be this distance, which is little r of x, which in our case is going to be the line, which is r of x equals x divided by 4. Let's go ahead and set this up. The volume V equals pi times the integral from the limits of integration, because the x-coordinate of this point of intersection is 16. We are going to integrate from x equals 0 to x equals 16. The integrand function is going to be the square of big R of x, which is the square of the outer radius. Big R of x is equal to f of x, which equals the square root of x. So we have the square of the square root of x, and then minus the square of little r of x. Little r of x is the inner radius controlled by the line. Little r of x is x divided by 4, giving us the square of x divided by 4. Let's go ahead and simplify the integrand function. Don't forget about the pi, that's a common error. The integrand function is simply x minus 1/16 x squared. Now we determine the antiderivative, which gives us pi times, the antiderivative is x squared divided by 2, or 1/2 x squared, minus 1/16 times x cubed divided by 3, which is 1/48 x cubed. Now we determine pi times the difference of big F of 16 and big F of 0. Big F of 16 is 1/2 times the square of 16 minus 1/48 times the cube of 16 minus, when x is 0, both terms are 0. Simplifying, we have pi times the difference of 128 and 256/3, which simplifies to 128 divided by 3 pi. And because this is volume, this would be cubic units. And now we rotate the same region about the y-axis, which means now the solid region will look something like this, because we are rotating about the y-axis, and the representative rectangle is now going to be horizontal because it's always perpendicular to the axis of rotation when using the washer method. Notice the thickness of the rectangle is delta y, which is why we integrate with respect to y. And now the outer radius, in this case big R of y, is this distance, which is controlled by the line, and the inner radius, little r of y, is this distance, controlled by the square root function. Notice we do have to have big R and little r as functions of y this time. So let's write f of x equals square root x as y equals square root x, and write g of x equals x divided by 4 as y equals x divided by 4. To write these as functions of y, we need to solve for x. Squaring both sides of y equals the square root of x, we have y squared equals x. And again, the square root function is the inner radius, little r of y. So now we know little r of y equals y squared. Solving y equals x divided by 4 for x, we have x equals 4y. And the line gives us the outer radius, big R of y. We know big R of y equals 4y. The volume of the solid when rotating about the y-axis is v equals pi times the integral. For the limits of integration, because we're integrating with respect to y, and the point of intersection here is 16 comma 4, we integrate from y equals 0 to y equals 4. And the integrand function is the square of big R of y, which is the square of 4y, minus the square of little r of y, which is the square of y squared, dy. Let's simplify the integrand function. The square of 4y is 16y squared, minus the square of y squared is y to the fourth. Now we determine the antiderivative, and again, don't forget about the pi. We have 16 times y cubed divided by 3, or 16 thirds y cubed, minus y to the fifth divided by 5, or 1 fifth y to the fifth. And we have pi times big F of 4 minus big F of 0. When y is 4, we have 16 thirds times the cube of 4 minus 1 fifth times the fifth power of 4, minus when y is 0, both terms are 0. This gives us pi times the difference of 1024 divided by 3 minus 1024 divided by 5, which is equal to 2048 divided by 15 pi. And again, they do want the exact value, so we'll stop here, but the units would be cubic units. I hope you found this helpful.